Well, hello people, and welcome back to part 14 of Egginburgh, our Cities Skylines 2 series. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Welcome back to the town of Invernegg, and we actually had a really nice comment last episode. We were talking about the lack of use of the intercity trains, however, a wonderful comment from our beautiful viewer Harsh actually gave us a great suggestion. So what we're actually going to do is delete all three of the current train lines that we have across Egginburgh. And what we're going to do instead is draw one single train line that runs from one outside connection all the way through the towns to the other one. So we're going to come over here to the one we made last time. Mount Vista is where that goes to. And then we're going to come into Invernegg, and then we'll come through these lines. This is going to go all the way through to Whiskey. We'll stay on the outside connection here, I think. And then run it through to Amasa over there. And then it can essentially come back and just mirror its stops as it heads back through the towns. Really great idea. Hope this is going to really increase the usage on one single line rather than having it split over multiple. So, wonderful. And this also gives us the opportunity to use these platforms for maybe a direct line from Invernegg to Bourbon up to Whiskey eventually once we get out there. But for right now, that should be the only train line that we need. So this is from the outside connection, Invernegg to Whiskey, and then back to the outside connection again. So we'll check that at the end of the episode and see just how many more people decide to actually use that train line. It should hopefully be quite a lot more, kind of amalgamating them all onto one of them anyway. There's another passenger train as well. Wonderful. Cool. So today's episode, we're going to be working on the Technical University that I asked you guys for input last episode. Now, this should be quite a fun little campus build, I think. So first of all, I really want to start layering the town of Invernegg. So last episode, we worked on getting this first waterfront layer in. And now we want to work on this sort of spot over here, right? I want this to be a big technical campus and also a geology campus as well, I guess, because it's also going to be tied into the fact that there's local mines nearby, which I think is quite appropriate for the local industry, isn't it? So first of all, I want to grab a layer that this campus is going to sit on. And why don't we go for four contour lines above the rail? We don't get any cliff texture there, showing, do we? Which I might want a little bit of cliff texture, actually. Why don't we go for a couple more contour lines? There we go. Let's push that all up against the existing rail network. And then all the way through here too. And I imagine we're just going to have the road or the entrance into the facility come off of this little national road that will eventually run to Bourbon as well. I'm really looking forward to getting stuck into that town of Bourbon, actually. It's going to be a lot more American inspired, which I think with the assets and the current gameplay loop of CS2, the game certainly lends itself more towards American style building, I think. So especially a lot of those apartment buildings are very sort of East Coast America inspired, aren't they? At least I think so anyway. So we got this set up now. Let's just re-soften everything around, and this should give us a pretty significant space for our campus. So I almost want this to be a bit of a kind of like really prestigious, cool scientific facility. So in between the campus and the rail, we want tons of trees. And I reckon we'll go for a lot of spruce forest. I also want to get a lot of this over the other side of town as well, between the mines. So let's get these spruce trees in. We want really thick forest, as much as we can get through here. And then we'll also do it against the boundary of the campus here as well. I'm not entirely sure if we want to call this a campus today. I guess it's more of a kind of technology research institute, I think, as opposed to an outright university. But maybe the university can be involved in that sort of stuff. But wonderful, we've also seen that forest grow up around the mines that we did when we built it over here now, right? Really makes a difference. Really hoping that CO eventually just gives us the option to turn off the tree growth mechanic. I remember in early access, we asked why we couldn't have full grown trees. And the answer we got was because we might cheese the forestry mechanic, yet we're all rolling in absolute billions after a couple of milestones. So, not really legitimate, is it? But whatever, right? Get some spruce forest in, we'll let this grow up. Fabulous. So let's come into our development tree, because we need to unlock a few more buildings today. So we want to come into education, and we want to grab the technical uni. We'll have this one here. And then the geological research center over here. So the Geological Research Center is a facility for performing geological research, obviously, and field studies. It helps discover larger underground deposits of oil and ore. Does it really? Wonderful. Okay, well, we'll have that as well then, shall we? And then I was thinking I want to come into communications and I want to grab the server farm for this build as well. And there's possibly some other things I want to get to. I think we'll also do a prison at some place or at some point around Invernegg. Maybe over by the industry we'll have the prison. We'll see what happens with that. Cool. So let's talk about positioning. So we're going to have a road through here. Let's go ahead and upgrade this off of the national road. Stick on our topography lines as well. And let's just feed this right the way up here. Not entirely sure if we'll have an exit out of the campus, maybe a bridge over the rail line at some point. We'll wait and see what happens on it. So the technical uni is a big old chungus. So if we were to have it here, I just want to first of all examine the positioning in the town, because again, as I mentioned at the start of the episode, and the layers in Cities 2 are very much part of my detailing sort of approach, if we like. So to have the campus there, I think it's quite nice, isn't it? Especially once all those trees are growing up, it's got a little bit of mystery to it as well. You can imagine kind of walking along Main Street in Invernegg, can't you? Just seeing that building through the tree line there. So I'm pretty happy with that sight line. But I think it definitely deserves to have its own sort of entrance road, I think, doesn't it? So why don't we do... Let's try and get it roughly centered. I'm not massively worried about perfect mirroring for this. So we'll do 12 meters and then we'll get a bit of continuous curve and we'll do a little 32 meter curve here. There we go. And then feed that back in to the entrance over this side. Fabulous. I'm really going to miss my prop line tool today. I can already tell. Cool. So let's turn off road snapping and then we will align. So I don't want the building itself to be centered on the entry road. I'd much rather have that little garden in the middle of the building centered against the road. That way it kind of makes sense, right? Yeah, I think rather than centralizing the entire asset, centralizing this pathway will help bring the build to life a little bit more, I hope. And just as a side note, what a beautiful asset, right? Really, this is the first time I've seen the Technical University. There's a lot of the late game development tree assets I simply just haven't seen, but this is a really nice one, isn't it? The little gardens in it too. Oh, it's nice, but at the same time, I also want to do a lot of this detailing myself. So it's a bit of a double-edged sword, isn't it? Cool, so I think what we will do is snap to building as well, or snap to the edge of the building at least, and we'll wrap this up entirely with pedestrian road. Because I do want roads running through this campus as well, because I think we're also going to have one of the specialized industry buildings in here as well today. Cool, so we can cut straight across there with the pedestrian street. I'm happy with that. We'll also go ahead and get some tree linings on this road as well. On both sides alongside some grass as well. Get a bit more importance. Something like that. And then I reckon the middle would probably benefit from a little walking pathway as well. Although we want no snapping on for that. And we can see we just want to eye it up so it sits in the middle. And we'll have that go straight up to the top. Is that going to change my positioning? It does a little bit, doesn't it? It was a slightly. That's okay then. Bit better. Trees in there will go quite nicely as well, I think, won't they? Also delete the ones that are a little bit stray. Yes, so you do need, of course, your research services. That's all the deal that I'm here. You are going to need lights. And that should connect you into the power grid, I believe. You happy? Yes, there we go. And then water pipes as well. We will grab these ones here and just feed them under the road. And stick them onto there. Everyone happy? Indeed they are. Cool, so that's one asset in. And it's really impressive, isn't it? Especially on the approach on the train here as well. Once you've got passenger trains running to Bourbon. It's going to be a real eye draw, isn't it? So let's move on to our next asset now. We actually unlocked it last episode and I thought it would work quite nicely in this build. And this is the switch on. So it is a factory, if you like, from the humble toaster to the self-organizing sock drawer. This factory makes everything that runs on electricity. Going to give us +2 industrial efficiency citywide and also +1 college graduation chance. I'm thinking with this being a sort of technical research facility, we can make use of the sort of huge electronics firm that also has a presence on campus, if you like. Okay? So again, angles are always important. And I think this asset here, the switch on factory, again, it really looks like it belongs with the technical university, doesn't it? I think I'm happy to have a bit more of an industrial presence on site. This is what I mean about not kind of strictly treating it as a university campus. It's more of the fact I want to have it as a bit of a research institute, I suppose. So I want to align this road, or this asset rather, with a perfect 90 degree angle from the train line. And we'll also have another line coming through here now, saving three tiles between the campus road. I'll have that come up there. And then we'll also do three tiles between the road and the train here. That's not too close, is it? Now a little bit of softening will make that blend in a little bit more there as well. That to sandwich the train line in between some more infrastructure. Right, we'll hit the road guideline of the pedestrian street at 180 degrees if we can find it. There we go. Bring this up as well. And then we'll just have a happy curve. Special. Cool. So now we have an orientation for which we can align. Switch on factory. So let's get that back in. We'll have this, you know, snap to roadside again for this one. So I'd also like a pedestrian road as well. Sorry, I'm just going to do this. I realize we're jumping back and two between menus. So I want a pedestrian road to run the opposite side of this. So let's also turn off zoning cell length and grid. I don't want it to move me around. The 90 degrees would be there. Let's draw that out as well. Not massively precious about saving zone in here because we're not going to have many zones in this way. We'll have a little bit of office elsewhere. Cool. So with that in mind, let's have this now go there, I reckon. Again, just taking a look from the rest of the town. Another big important bit of infrastructure for Invernegg, isn't it? Yeah, I like that there. I think it's going to be quite nice. Cool. So we now have another one of the signature buildings in. I'm going to be very happy with that. Returning to the idea of the campus a second, I would like to also have some sports facilities here. So let's go ahead and drop in an angle here. We'll grab ourselves some parks. Let's do some sports. We'll do a couple of tennis courts. Let's go for all of them there. And then can we get a basketball court in behind? We're able to have you there. Yes, I like that. I reckon we can map all this out with some pathways as well. There's also a community pool as well, isn't there? I believe. It's under, yeah, leisure parks. Be good as well if the campus could have a sports team of some sort. I think I'd be happy to include the American football pitch in here as well. Yeah, I think we'll do that. Also grab this pedestrian road now and bring it down together. Fabulous. And I think because this kind of looks like it wants to have roads around the back, doesn't it? And then again, that's not really, you know, the delivery aspect of the assets over here, isn't it? I was thinking, well, we probably want road along the back, but this looks like another entrance into the building just for people as opposed to vehicles. So I think I'm happy for more pedestrian road to also feature there as well. We can get a bit of a wider junction in there as well, can't we? Yeah, I think we'll go with that. And then I think on the edge of the asset here, we will actually return to road. And then I reckon we'll probably feed that same distance down the back this side of the campus as well, saving three tiles. And then just feed that back into that road over there. And hopefully we can just bring this straight down, something like that. And then that pedestrian road can go right into that junction there. But CS2's road tours are very fun when you do stuff like that. So just so seamless, very much appreciated. Cool. Okay, so the campus is really coming up together there, isn't it? So the other key asset we wanted to include, of course, was the geology research center here. So it is a facility. We've already read that, haven't we? It was plus 200% ore deposits and plus 200% ore deposits. Okay, so let's actually see this in action then, shall we? So let's have a look at our natural resources. So of course we've got tons of ore over here that we're currently extracting. Let's go ahead and place this there for right now. Okay, so it just doubles the size of them then, does it? Not creating new ones, which I guess makes sense. So if you missed that, we'll have this one here. Okay, it's a regular sized ore deposit right now. But we will then throw down our Geological Research Institute. And it doubles in size pretty much, doesn't it? So I guess, yeah, all these have really expanded now, haven't they? So we could expand the mining operations if we wanted to. Pretty cool building though. Let's have a look at it ourselves. It's got a lot of cool wood paneling on the front of it. It's not what I expected a Geological Research Institute to look like, to be honest, although now I say that, I'm not really sure what I expected anyway. Cool, so where do we want to have this? I reckon perhaps opposite the design here. Go ahead and grab the building. There's the a nice point of centralization. We could have it directly opposite the university plaza here, which does make it sit quite nicely. But I do kind of prefer the side entrances, especially this back entrance here, actually is rather quite nice as the main entrance, isn't it? Kind of keep the delivery bays toward the back if you like, so I think that's what we'll run with. Let's go ahead and get some roads. And we'll give this a little bit of breathing room. Let's go ahead around a tile each side, also amending the terrain here because I don't want it to be sat on a hill. So we'll give it a tile of breathing space all the way around. And then you can see now, right, how it extends those tiles out, which is rather nice actually. And then just a case of flipping it around 180 degrees essentially. Yeah, which then keeps those path decals going out a little bit. And I think I'm much happier with that side facing the road. Or facing the technology university rather. I think that's going to be quite nice, isn't it? I'm going to be happy with that. I reckon we could also do with a little shuttle bus that takes people from here to the train station, couldn't it? Which probably means we want to start introducing buses to Invernegg today. Which gives me just cause for the a bus station here too. How are we doing for buses currently? Let's jump back to Port Whiskey for a hot minute and check out our bus depot. Around here somewhere, isn't it? That's the park one. There's the bus one. No, we've still got capacity. Yeah, there's a decent amount left, yeah. 26 to 35 is fine. We'll definitely get the last of those buses in Invernegg. So where do we want a bus station? I reckon in and around the density is going to be sensible, isn't it? So if we hit a sewage threshold, I think we have, haven't we? We have indeed. I guess we could just grab the wastewater treatment plant that we actually placed last episode. We really need an industrial area for Invernegg. I want to kind of put it over here. Then we will just pop it there for right now. But when we come to develop this industrial area, we'll factor in the wastewater treatment for that. But for right now, that should give the city a lot more sewage processing. Yeah, we're pretty good right now. We'll also stick a large parking lot in the campus as well. See how many people actually use this. But then returning to the idea of a bus station, if we can crack this open here, and then I reckon we can squeeze it in right in the middle of Invernegg town, I reckon. Have a little bus stop here. Not be too bad, is it? Don't think so. We've got so many demands at the minute. The city's just pure growth. Possibly a good opportunity actually to work in some student accommodation over here as well. Yeah, but either way, let's go ahead and get those bus lines flowing. So we'll add in a stop. They won't go on pedestrian roads, will they? Should still be able to drive around this one though. That should be quite cool. Let's have a bus stop here. We'll also have one on the entrance in and out of the campus. Then it can come and stop at the station itself, and then we'll have stops on the outside the medical, university building. No, not medical university, what's that called? Because I'm so unfamiliar with all the assets at the minute. Health Research Institute is that building there. They can come right down Main Street, stop against all this commercial, getting people back down to the canal district over here too. And then there's taxis coming and going from the station as well. And then we'll have a bus station. We want that straight outside the building. I think we do, although I need to centralize it a little bit better. In between those two advertising signs, that looks about good, doesn't it? I think it does. Superb. So we'll do a line now through Invernegg. Cool. And do we want to consider possibly upgrading any bus lanes here? I think a bus lane down the main road might be quite welcome, actually. I reckon we'll stick that on both sides, at least on the main street. Once it comes back into the town centre, I think we'll leave it in that regard. Yeah, have it down the main road there, and I guess we could also do it with the one-way side heading into town. Why doesn't it connect there? That's so irritating. Absolutely does my head in that. I hate the fact it won't do it like that, but whatever. It's, at least it's still there, right? Cool. So that should give us maximum bus usage now. 33 of 35. Yeah, so next bus line we need, we're going to need a bus depot. Which again, I reckon we'll factor that building into an industrial build over here to come satisfy some of this demand that we've got. But either way, we now have a bus running back and to from the campus to the train station, stopping at a new town bus station. Well, I hope we see lots of people moving around here now. Lots of people getting back on the dual carriageway as well. Nice to see, isn't it? Nice and busy. I don't really want parking on these roads though, so let's go ahead and say no thank you. There we go. Cool. Yeah, I see some people using these little slip lanes now to get into town. That's what we want to see. I think, you know, the more connectivity we can generate for this national road network, the better. I don't just want to try and stick so rigidly into practice of road hierarchy. I definitely think going for connections is a lot more sensible thing to do. Cool. So, other building I wanted to include in this campus itself was also the server farm, which is rows and banks of raw computing power, provide immense resources to handle network traffic, can be upgraded with fiber optic cables and advanced computers. So this asset here is lovely. We ended up using this actually in New Friendwood for those that watched our early access series. So let's connect in here, and then what I would like to do is just set this building back a little bit on its own road. And this should have quite a nice sight line from sort of the approach from Bourbon coming down this road, which I'm just going to draw out a little bit further. Let's go for here. Well, Bourbon's going to be about here, isn't it? Is that a car crash? Jesus, there's loads of car crashes in Whiskey. Are we okay? What's wrong? He's come off the road there. He's just crashed there as well. One up here. Goodness gracious. No one in Whiskey can drive. Is that a road maintenance issue, I wonder? Do we possibly want another road maintenance depot now? There's a lot of crashes there, isn't there? It doesn't give me road condition, I guess, is the barometer we want, isn't it? That's got quite a bad road condition there, apparently, for some reason. The rest of it around it is absolutely fine. I mean, road condition, according to the heat map, is apparently okay. So, I would take that information as the fact that we don't need more road maintenance. And the one we currently have placed is fully upgraded. All 15 vehicles with 110% efficiency as well. Although, there you go, I didn't know minus 6 because of sick employees. First time seeing that. Interesting. Yeah, maybe that's just the problem then. Still getting people whinging a bloody high rent in Whiskey. Right, let's find out what's going on. So there's an educated adult. Educated teen, child. So she's clearly paying the rent then. So educated is whinging of too high a rent. Okay. So let's have a look here. So I'm happy to bring that down maybe 2 points. I want to tax uneducated. I want to encourage people with more educated Sims to come into the city. We are making a ton of money here. That's 6 million through offices. What? That's insane. What are we producing so much of? Software and finance and media? Well, I guess there's money in media, isn't there? Can't complain at that. Okay, yeah, let's then bring those uneducated taxes down, or educated taxes, and we'll see if that helps affect it. Apparently this car has burnt down, but it is okay. Yeah, alright then. Car crashes seem to have cleared up. I really like whiskey. Nice little town, isn't it? Also, oh, there you go. We just had that flashing warning, didn't we? That there's not enough buses now. Maybe we do want another bus depot then. Maybe we do. Although it has instantly gone away. Anyway, we are digressing. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, no vehicles. Okay, yeah, we need another bus depot as well then. Again, everyone close your eyes. I'm just going to put this in and around our taxi depot, actually. And we'll develop them into a larger industrial estate, possibly next episode, I think. Over this side of the town, we'll do some industry. Maybe get the prison out here as well. We'll wait and see. It's pissing down all the time, isn't it? Never stops. Anyway, never found before we got distracted. So yeah, I'd love to have this beast here. And let's just place it down and just get a sense of its sort of positioning within the campus. Like another major building for the facility, isn't it? And another really important asset for the skyline of Invernegg as it continues to grow. I don't think we'll have too many high rises over this side of the town. Not a lot of high density office, etc. Yeah, I think that's what I'm after. I just want this pine forest to grow up. I want the whole thing to be surrounded by forest. Again, driving into town on the dual carriageway is a pretty impressive approach, isn't it? The Chungus building, this one, the server farm. It is nice, though. Yeah. Okay. And again, its entrances here lend itself very well to pedestrian roads, don't they? Especially around this side here, we can get a bit of a pedestrian key. If anyone wants to come and sit and eat lunch out here at the back of the server farm, they have pretty impressive views of infrastructure. See the road here too. So one of the biggest challenges I've found of playing Cities Skylines 2, I'd love to also hear about your guys' experience of this as well, is getting used to the scale of everything again, you know? Just assets in Cities 1 are just so much smaller, and yeah, it really changes the way I play, I think. When we're playing with such large assets like this. So I'm actually going to manipulate the terrain here to activate a bit of cut and fill and retaining wall, I think we'll have a retaining wall run along the back of the campus, or the server farm rather. So let's do this and kind of make it part of the building. So we'll bring it through here. Now it should be pretty easy manipulated here. Let's push that out a little bit. Just don't want it to fall as it goes along. Push this side out a little bit too. Yeah, it is dipping down there though, isn't it? Which is not what we want to happen. Unless anybody wants lunch on an angle, then they can do that there. Yeah, that's what I'm after. And all of this looks like it's friendly to pedestrianising. And we'll bring... Do you want another parking lot outside it? I'm going to double up the medium. Possibly. We'll try that out. Yeah, and then I reckon we'll bring this up to the edge of that building, feed that back down, and then hook the pedestrian road into there, and possibly back into the campus and into the other pedestrian street as well. I think I'm happy with that. Although I definitely want to just manipulate the terrain around here, though, so it doesn't look as obvious there. Tiny little bits of level, and then tiny, tiny bits of soften, maybe on a lower brush strength, actually, is what I'm after here. Yeah, a little bit of that should be good. And that should give me... Oh, that looks a little nasty there, doesn't it? There we go. Now people have a bit more of a solid back to the server farm. Makes it look kind of part of the building there, doesn't it? And also extends the pedestrianisation out around the edge of the asset too. Hopefully we'll actually have people walking around this way to use these props. It'd be nice. I don't know if they do get used or not. But that adds in the server farm. And I'm happy with that. We've also got our buses arriving here now too. Someone just got off. We will see some... folk waiting. Yeah, there's a few people waiting at the stop there, isn't there? Very nice. Fabulous. They're going to get across and going to walk up the middle. No, we're going that way. That's fine. I'm happy if you use my pedestrian routes. special. I really like that. It looked quite nice, didn't it? And then I think for some on-site housing, I'd love to bring in some alleyway roads, and let's go for 3x4. I think that's what I want. If we were to stick a 3x4 apartment in here, I think I'd be happy with one of those. What was the length here? 41 meters. So we'll stick it back up to there. Yeah, and I think we can just keep that pattern going, and that should give us some on-site apartments. We could also explore the possibility of what some smaller low-rent housing might also look like here as a student accommodation alternative, I suppose. We'll see what grows up between apartments and low-rent housing as to what's going to be the best option. Imagine low-rent housing might be a little tall. I see that one there. I'll have to wait and see. But either way, that does feel like a good point for a detailing time lapse. I might go put in some more sports fields and get lots of pathways around here too. We'll do some trees up the central moor reservation here as well. And wrap the whole thing in more pine forest too. And I might do a little bit more zoning up around the town here as well, just to help blend that bus station in. Maybe play with some of the slopes here as well, because it's a little bit gnarly around the grid in some places. But one final look before it becomes detailed at the new campus of Invernegg. We'll have to give this a name as well, won't we? If you guys can come up with some sort of, I don't know, I guess geological, technical inspired name, might be quite fun. If you fancy it, please leave suggestions down below. I really like seeing the trains move around here too. The infrastructure around Invernegg is quite cool. Big fan of it so far. It's really nice. But either way, we shall do some detailing and then we'll be right back. Thank you. before we do go to a detailed review, we'll have a little glance over at our station now, which hopefully is attracting quite a few passengers, isn't it? Then I got 1,001 passengers right through that one line, so thank you for that suggestion. Yeah, that definitely seems to have worked, so hopefully now Egginburgh's trains will be getting quite a bit more use as we move forward in the city. So guys, welcome back to a detailing review right on the precipice of winter, so my apologies for the incoming relentless white. However, the town, or the university, or the campus, or the facility, not entirely sure what it is, but it sits very nicely now, just kind of sat just above Invernegg. And again, I mentioned at the start of the episode, you know, really developed this side of the town today with that layer, haven't we? And then we'll do several more builds along this hillside here to really develop Invernegg into a significant space. But either way, we'll come down the main road, actually, shall we? So we've got our buses stopping here now. There are a few folks waiting, and we do now have the capacity for more buses to arrive to and from Invernegg, which will be nice. Lots more public transport kicking in for the Sims. I got some asymmetrical road action down. Oh, look at that train. Oh, God, it's so good. Absolutely love the layers around Invernegg, and it's only going to get more layered as well. Yeah, a little bit of asymmetry at the junction here, back onto the highway. And then we peel back up here. Oh, it's such a shame. It's gone. It's because of winter. The worst possible timing. But either way, we'll get used to it, right? It's part of the game. So, yes, we have our very white campus now. Lots of path designs all over the place. We'll get kind of a bird's eye view of the perspective. Yeah, so little crisscrosses. Just got some oaks in here, which will look really nice once they're all grown up. And then lots of repeated pine patterns. Around the back of the Geological Institute, I gave them a little stone quarry here, almost as it's like some test rocks if they need a little test field before any practices are put into industrial scale mining in the actual mines to the north of the town. Then they can do that there as well. I guess test rocks maybe is what they have out here. But a nice little way to, again, squeeze in some more stone mining into the production chain. Our little student accommodation apartments have turned out nicely here. The 4x3 European apartments are pretty much perfect for what I wanted, really. So quite happy with these here. Little snowman there as well. It's quite cute, isn't it? Very nice indeed. Then some shops. I don't have chemtrail chemicals, which I'm entirely sure that should be here. But whatever. Maybe it's all legal in Egginburgh, who knows. And then a little 26-9, I guess, over here. I guess it's a play on 7-Eleven or something, is it? I don't know. I'm not sure. 24-7, maybe. And then office space over this side with some car parking, which is slowly filling up. And then our big server farm is over here too. Haven't put any upgrades on the server farm just yet. We're pretty well stocked for communication at the minute. So, yeah, we don't really need any upgrades on it. But when they do start to complain again, we could do, of course, that have that upgrade capacity. I really like as well how the server farm sits here on the entrance. Definitely you can see as you're driving past it, you're like, oh. It's sort of place, if you drive down the highway and you see something just to the left of the road and you're like, oh, I wonder what that is. Want that to keep, kind of be this place, you know. Also dropped in a med clinic as well for on-site health. We're actually getting quite a few injured over at the American football pitch, so found it appropriate to have an on-site medical facility. This is a fully upgraded med clinic, so probably won't need any more medical facility in and around Invernegg after this, because we've already got two med clinics. And I imagine we'll put the big medical university over in Bourbon by the river and the bridge, maybe, because that's a super chungus asset as well. And then through here, put some office space in just to help satisfy some of those demands. Pine trees in between the pedestrian road and the actual road. All of our little sports fields have had pathways drawn up against them, and this is kind of the most effective detail in a field in vanilla CS2 at the minute. It's just path linings and bush linings where possible. Also dropped in some more sports fields over here as well. We actually have some homeless living on the basketball court to the campus, which isn't ideal. That's probably a sign that we maybe need some low rent housing in Invernegg. Should we do that while we're here? Actually, just they weren't there earlier. they must have just moved in. Can we get some low rent housing over here, maybe, and maybe some on the edge of town out here? Maybe we can have a tower over there as well. See if we can provide some low rent housing for the homeless Sims that are currently living in the snow on the basketball court. So there we go, they've gone. Is that it? Was that all they needed? Well, they left that court anyway. They're still on this one. But yeah, hopefully that low rent housing will allow them to live indoors anyway. Yes, and over here, another office space as well, just a single large 6x6 to kind of accompany these larger assets over here. So lots of office zoning around here. And a little bit more commercial and parking next to a football field. And then, of course, it all sits up against this line, and it looks tremendously cool, actually, when we see a cargo train pass through here. Hopefully we'll see one before the end of the episode anyway, but I really like how the town's developed, all these little layers squeezed in against each other in different networks, and traffic's still flowing really nicely down the couplet. I've done some more lane maths here as well, with the three lanes people come into the town, and also done one-way networks here, going right, and then this one goes left, and then the next one goes right. They're just distributing where and how that traffic can turn on and off the couplet system here. And traffic's nice, especially considering this is also hooked into a major highway as well currently, with the interchange down here. It's actually performing surprisingly well. We'll hopefully keep seeing nice traffic flow right through this town centre here. But either way, I am tremendously happy with Invernegg's campus. But otherwise, guys, that is going to do it for today. Let's thank you all so much for watching. If you've enjoyed it, likes, comments, and shares below. Really do help me out and show the video to more people. Equally as much if you haven't enjoyed it, please feel free to leave me a dislike as well. It's a lot of fun playing with these larger assets in Cities 2, and I hope today's campus adds a real kind of purpose to Invernegg's mining sort of technological industrial theme that the town is running with the mines nearby. And this whole facility sits really nicely as a big kind of modular build on the kind of back hillside of Invernegg. An enormous shout out as always to the beautiful human beings with fantastic character that are the Overcharged Egg Patrons, with a special shout out to Felix Wilkinson. Thank you for all of your support, guys. If you're interested in supporting the channel further, we have links down to Instant Gaming, where you can get loads of cheap codes for yourself, and Patreon below. They're the best ways to do it, so check them out if that's something you're interested in. But otherwise, please do enjoy today's cinematics, but I'll show up and leave it there. Let's thank you all so much for watching, and as always, enjoy the rest of your day.